Good morning, velocipedians. Welcome to another beautiful day. Again, a little bit of haze, but still glorious. The bees are loving this bush. Of course, they're not here now I'm talking. So, today's little ride. Something you won't have seen for a while. If you've just been following these lockdown rides, you won't have seen this one at all. There are two videos of this further down my channel. It's the custom Batavus from I think the 1970s, early 80s. It was silver with one of those awful Shimano Positron derailleurs that operates by a wire, not a cable. So yeah, I basically used the frame, which was silver. It was fine, nothing wrong with it, I just didn't like the colour. So I painted it in, this was actually supposed to be military olive, and this is the colour it turned out. No complaints though, very nice. And lots of little touches. A Mafak racer brake, which is the best brake in the world, with the best brake pads to go with them, the Salmon Cool Stop, the lovely colour coordinated tyres, Schwalbe Century. They issued some special edition tyres, presumably for their century, and original graphics, which I managed to paint round. But this is the interesting feature of this bike. It's a Fichtel and Sachs Duomatic from the 1960s, 66 I think this is, and rare to find in a 36 spoke form. I was lucky to get hold of it. And it is a two-speed hub with brake, but no cables. The second video about this bike is specifically showing you how to ride with one of these. So I won't go into the details again now. Go and look down my channel for the Duomatic hub, and it shows you this hub in operation, how to change gear with it and stop with it and such like. So, without further ado, I think it's time to go for a little spin. I've got the big shop to do later, so won't be able to take a bike for that. Have to take the old station wagon, and I'm just taking my exercise now while I can on this lovely machine. Let's get on with it, shall we? Bicycle. After all the battles on the path racer yesterday, I want some quietude today. I don't know how well you can see it, but the light through these trees is wonderful. guard. I haven't stopped since I heard it earlier. I'm going to stop now. Excuse the noise. As usual, the traffic is now back up to pre-lockdown levels. It took them a few days to reduce it a bit, and then obviously they got tired of obeying the rules, and so the gammon brought their cars back out again, and it's just traffic as usual. Obviously I'm not counting vans, probably about 50% of the cars. There's an awful lot of them have families in. Right, I'm going to look at this mudguard, see if I can get rid of that noise. Well, I've evened up the distance, the gap on each side now. So, hopefully, that'll be better. I think what it needs ultimately is better mudguard stays. It's only got one stay, and it's the lightweight type of stay that normally goes on plastic mudguards. I think I need to put a proper Dutch metal stay on here, because this is an aluminium mudguard. On the rear I have a thick wraparound stay, which is much better. I've been thinking about having a bit of a reconfiguration on this bike. I'm not all that happy with the handling on this bike either, the steering. It used to have North Road handlebars on when it was a 3-speed, and it handled fine. I never noticed it, so it must have handled fine. It's a little bit better when I have this natty green Batavus branded pouch on the front with something in it. So that leads me to conclude that this fork, as you can see, has got quite a bit of offset rake on it, which is this down here, the amount by which the hub is set forward from the line of the steering. That reduces the trail. Trail is what gives stability to handling. So these low trail configurations like this are usually meant for having a front load. This hasn't got a front load. Not only that, but I've put these Belleville handlebars on, which now put my hands well behind the steering axis, so there's nothing on that front there with those long rake forks. So I have a choice of what to do. If I want to keep the fancy schmancy handlebars, I can either put a handlebar stem with a longer reach forward. That'll bring everything forward. That will reduce it a little bit. I could change the forks, for forks with a shorter rake. That would do it. And I could fit different handlebars which have more of a forward, something like a North Road where your hands are about here. Now when I had North Roads on, it was fine. That means stripping these handlebars off, of course. So what I'm thinking is take the whole handlebar assembly out, the whole shebang. I've got room there to put a second brake lever on, so I can put the handlebars in something else, in something with more forgiving geometry, and put some more conventional handlebars in this bike. It's a shame because those continental style handlebars, they go nicely with the bike, the reverse pull lever, and it adds to the overall aesthetic, the feel of the bike visually, if not physically. But you've got to balance these things with rideability. If the bike is not as pleasant to ride, then what's the point of it as a bicycle? I always say that my favourite bike is the bike I'm riding right now, and the bike that I'm riding right now is more likely to be one that I enjoy riding. I'll reach for the bike that I enjoy riding. If I end up in the situation where I've got to take a bike out because I feel duty bound, because I haven't had it out for a while, I need to look at why I'm not riding it. My bikes are made to be ridden. So yeah, I've got to look at it seriously. So it's getting busy here now. Not much of a social distancing opportunity, and I've been out a little while, so I think it's probably time to get moving back. I'm going to go back via the perimeter cycle track that runs actually outside of the park, beside the roads, all the way around the park and back in a homeward direction. I've brought you this way before on one of the spring equinox rides a couple of weeks ago, 2 days before the lockdown in fact. That's Blackpool Zoo in there. Photo coming up. Dutch bike, tulips, had to be done. Fortunately you can't hear the traffic on a still photo. Now this is better. This area is normally busy. It's a shopping street there and it's quiet. So I think that concurs with pictures that people are putting on the internet of town centre shopping streets deserted because the shops are shut. So it seems to be the shopping streets are quiet because the shops are shut. The people are mostly in the suburbs. And of course they're not sitting outside the pubs. So yeah, we've got this strange situation where the centres are empty and the suburbs are busy. Ooh. Climbed over the railway bridge. And now I can just break when the lead rises down this side. Back pedal brake. I don't like the twitchy handling, situations like that. That cycle route actually goes further along the footpath and comes out here. So I cheated a little bit. So we're parallel with the main road now, but this is blocked at one end, so it can't be rat-around by cars. Not an unpleasant street to live in, this. Except nobody can park, of course. There's a near the old homestead. I'm going to spend the rest of the day doing the big shop and then jobs around the house. Not really of interest to velocipedians, so I'll bid you a good day till tomorrow. Stay safe, of course. Keep riding if you can, and we'll see you tomorrow.